New at 5:30, inside the invasion. New research suggests a type of Asian carp has invaded several of the Great Lakes, including Lake Erie. If the species isn't found and taken out of the lakes, or if it reproduces here, it could cause a serious problem to the ecosystem. News 4's Jen Shantz has the details. Jen?
Well, Nolina, this type of Asian carp isn't the flying kind like the ones you see behind me here. That's called the silver carp. But grass carp, which was what we're talking about today, they don't jump, but they do eat a lot. And that's where they pose the biggest problem. These fish can get to be 50 pounds, and they can eat up to 40% of their body weight a day in plants. So what's the big deal here, you might ask? Well, the fish we rely on in the Great Lakes for food and for sport need that plant matter for food and for cover from predatory birds. Imagine 20 pounds of it gone in a day just from one fish. It could cause a huge problem if these grass carp begin to reproduce. Experts say the wetlands, which they call the nursery to the Great Lakes, could be really harmed, which in turn will impact Lake Erie. So how did these things even get here? It's hard to know for sure, but cross-border smuggling is one guess from Great Lakes experts.
In some fish markets, the live Asian carp is a delicacy, or it's preferred. It's better than filleted, so you'd want to buy it live. And then once you sell a fish to somebody live, you really don't know at the end of the day what's going to happen to that fish, whether it's going to escape or end up on a dinner plate or somewhere in between, like has happened before, where you find them in ponds in the park or fountains in Toronto.
That's crazy, but they actually have been found in fountains in Toronto. Since 2002, Canada has caught more than 20 grass carp. We don't know how many there are here in Lake Erie around the Buffalo area, but the good news is they're not gonna bite you or harm you if they're swimming. They're big, they might be weird to look at, but they're not going to hurt you. It's really the fishermen who are gonna see the impact most, because the smallmouth bass, the walleye, the trout people like to fish for this summer, we might see them in smaller numbers.
And is grass carp legal in New York State?
It is legal. You just have to get a permit for it. So if you have like a pond in your backyard, a lot of times those can get kind of grassy. And grass carp actually are perfect to clean up that the moss-like vegetation at the bottom of the pond. So a lot of people do get grass carp. You just have to get a permit for them. And those grass carp cannot reproduce.
And are other states concerned about this? I mean, Canada, for example, they share borders with us and borders with Lake Erie. Are they concerned about this problem?
Yes, and the Great Lakes Fishery Commission gave kudos to our neighbors of the north and really said that they are on the forefront of this. They're counting the carp, they're making sure they're taking proactive actions to make sure that they don't procreate and move forward. So we are working hand and foot with Canada right now to make sure that our numbers match up and that we're working with them. And as this threat continues, they're going to be allies in this. And
we'll keep you posted. Story. All right, Jen, thank you so much. Appreciate that.